guys, welcome back to my channel. My name is Najma Ali. If you're new here, Karib Sana, if an old baby, but a goodie. Thank you so much. You know how it goes. You're the real OG. So guys, your girl Dem is in Mombasa, County 001. And today I'm going to show you something different, something that I've never done before. You guys told me that you want this kind of content, and whom am I to refuse, huh? So today I'm going to sell the best seller snack, or should I say Swahili snack, in Mombasa. So I'm going to take you to the market. The first process is to go get the Irish potatoes, because I'm going to make viazi karai for today, and we're gonna make with some porridge along here. So nan uji, it's just viazi. Unfortunately, leo hatutafanya uji. You're not going to make the wheat porridge that I wanted to show you guys. So we're just going to get the Irish potatoes. And yeah, come along with me. I will take you guys with me. And the sun is scorching hot, guys. And I'm dressed culturally. You know, this is just a common dress in Mombasa. It's a dera because of the heat. It's so light and you get so comfortable over here. You know, you don't want to be uncomfortable when you're doing the hustle. And yeah, so guys, that's it. I'll see you guys. Bye. Already here at the market, we want to get our potatoes so that we can just go and make our hustle for today. Okay. So, for how many crates? Just one crate. So we're going to get for only one crate, because we're not going to do much. Business is not so good as always because of this COVID thing. And I have my mask on, so don't judge. So yeah, come along, guys. Noon. So yeah, right now we're going to peel them, boil them, and then just make sure that we are making our sauces. We're going to make some tamarind sauce and some chili sauce. So guys, I hope you will enjoy the whole process with me. Bye bye.
Okay, so guys, we are already home, and we want to get along with the process. We're just going to start by peeling the Irish potatoes. As I told you guys, I'm just going to peel them as I put them there, because actually, by the way, one trick about these potatoes, if you don't put them at the water immediately, they're going to have some stains which are going to be so hard to remove. So that is why we're going to have a bucket just beside us full of water, or halfway full, so that we can avoid the stains. So yeah, watch me do it. Anyway guys, so how am I doing so far? Comment down below and tell me where you're watching me from, and smash that like button, guys. Smash that like button, subscribe to my channel. We're on the road to 10,000 subscribers.
So guys, you're done with peeling the potatoes. Now it's the session where I just want to get my jiko ready. This is an African jiko. We use this to cook sometimes if you don't have the gas, you know. It uses charcoal, guys. I don't think that there is nowhere in Africa that there is no charcoal. And also, you know, we want to minimize the expenses and the resources. We don't want to use the gas for something that you're going to get a profit of 10 or 20 shillings, Kenyan shillings. That is like,
I don't know, $1, not even $1, 0.5 or even less than $0.5, $0.25. So guys, is it worth it to use gas by making such a thing that will give you less income? I don't think that's worth it. So let me just get done with my Jiko. Comment down below how I'm doing so far and give this video a like. Smash that like button, guys. Already done with boiling our potatoes, so this is the positioning for today. I have my Jiko ready. Kid, you can just show them. You see, I'm waiting for the charcoal to not like totally burn up so that I can get to place my karai. This is what I'm going to use to fry my potatoes. And we have our oil here for today. This is gonna be enough, and then this to sieve the feel like this to sieve the dirt or the particles that were in the oil, you know? Because I'm not gonna buy new, you know, mafuta. Yeah, so this is the cooking oil, guys. And we have this to place our viazi karai, and we have our sauces. We have the chili sauce, and we also have the tamarind sauce right here. And then this is our grain flour. You can also use a wheat flour if you don't have this. This is the ungawadengu. So yeah, I think that is it the right name? Are you showing them my face? Yeah, I think this is the right name, the grain flour. You can also use the wheat flour, add some food color, some salt, and maybe some black pepper and a bit of water, because you don't want it to be so light. And then here we have our boiled Irish potatoes. So this is gonna be it for today. And then of course this is so important. So the main point of all this is to get the shmula. So this is where I'm going to collect my coins for today. Here, I have my tin here, and also have some change. It's a must for you to have some change, because you know, you might get clients coming here with notes and need some change. So, and I can see that our Jiko is ready. So let's get started for today, guys. Bismillah. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. You know, you have to remember God in whatever you do, so that God can bless your hustle, so that you get clients and get to sell out. You know, sometimes, not all the time you get to sell out, but I'm just hoping I'm going to sell out and, you know, earn my capital and profit back. So let us do this, guys. Let us do this. Comment down below what you have learned so far. Comment down below where you're watching me from, and don't forget to hit on that like button and subscribe, guys. We're on the road to 10,000 subscribers, and if you want more of this content, also let me know. Yeah, that's basically it. Cooking oil has already heat up, so I'm just going to start by washing my hands thoroughly, because we're not going to, you know, use dirty hands while cooking our potatoes. We don't want to give our client some food poisoning. We don't want to do that here, because I'm going to be using my hand to cook my potatoes and dip them in my cooking fry. So what kindly my videographer for today, kindly come closer to me. So this is my dengu flour, or is it my grain flour, as I told you guys. And these are my boiled Irish potatoes, and I'm just going to mix and make sure that I mix it so well. Oh, it's already heated up. So this is what I'm going to do. Bismillah. Jamani wateja ni waje waanze kuja. Najua kuna watu wapenda viazi vya moto moto kama mimi mwenyewe. So guys, I'm trying to be careful because I don't want to burn my hands. I mean, I'm still young, at my early 20s, with a scar at my hand. No, I don't want that.
So I'm really trying to be as careful as possible because I really don't want a scar on me at my age. I love me some flawless skin. So guys, I'm trying to be very careful. Because you don't want to kujitia hasara. To go on a loss. Guys, I really want my potatoes to like dry up because that is how, you know, us Swahili love our Irish potatoes. Like, we don't do it the way Nairobians do. We like our potatoes to be as dry and as crunchy as possible. And we want them hot. Like, we love eating them served while hot. So, yeah. I really hope I will get instant clients so that we don't have to warm up the potatoes again. And really hate that. Because you know what? When you get to warm up the potatoes again, they suck in a lot of cooking oil. And then you end up getting some other cooking oil. That will be like another expense of which we had never planned for. So I'm really trying that I get the instant clients. Hapa na hapa, pale na pale. Jamani watoto muje mununue viazi. Who else? Ladies, jamani viazi, 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 eh, viazi, chanza, viazi, eh, viazi.
Matati.
Gangapi?
Matati.
Nikutilie ukwaju?
Ukwaju kidogo na masala.
Ala, sawa, sawa. Na juice pia, kuna juice ndani.
Hey, juice ya donge.
Hey, guys, so we also have, just in case you pass by me on the streets of Likoni, Mombasa, Kenya, in Africa, we also have some very good passion juice. Inside the house, we don't want to get it here because we don't have a cooler yet. That is why sijazeka hapa. But we have some potatoes and some juice. I think our potatoes are ready. So this is our first round. So I'm really trying so hard to sieve the oil. We don't want to remove the potatoes with oil on them. That is what I'm trying to do. Wow, they are looking yummy and spicy and so fresh. They look so good. Guys, comment down below how I'm doing so far, and I'm loving this. I'm loving this hustle for sure. I'm really loving this experience. Remember, we only used only $1 to get the crate of potatoes. Just $1. And I'm going to sell 4 potatoes at 10 shillings only. So that is like 0.01 dollar. I'm not sure. Comment down below, guys. Leave a comment how I'm doing so far. Just leave a comment. So as I wanna serve my clients, but first let me just refill my pan very quick. Then serve my clients for today. Kazaha. So guys, this is our tamarind sauce. Our client doesn't want a lot of pepe, and that is our chili sauce. So let me just take this to how najua mteja ni mfalme jamani. Wateja kila siku lazima waanzaje kama mfalme. A client is a king. That is what I'm basically trying to tell you guys, for those who don't get me in Swahili.
Yamani, karibu.
Asante.
So, before our potatoes burn up, let's do this. We don't want our potatoes to burn, do we? No, they're still not yet dry. Kashiba. ¿Qué pasa? ¿Qué pasa? ¿Qué pasa? ¿Qué pasa? ¿Qué
pasa?
¿Qué pasa? ¿Qué pasa? ¿Qué pasa? ¿Qué pasa? ¿Qué pasa? ¿Qué pasa? ¿Qué pasa? ¿Qué pasa? ¿Qué pasa? ¿Qué pasa? ¿Qué pasa? ¿Qué pasa? ¿Qué pasa? ¿Qué pasa? ¿Qué pasa? ¿Qué pasa?
So the whole process, nothing is easy, guys. Nothing is easy. We had to go to the market, get the potatoes, peel them, boil them, wash them, heat up the jiko, fry them. That's not all. We had to make some sauces. All for what? Just a profit, 10 shillings or 20 shillings, guys. Kindly give this video a thumbs up. Make sure you like, comment, and subscribe.